Fight on!
You guys, what's up? Welcome back to Top Tier Arcade. My name is Steve, and we're back in the car because we're not going back on tour. We're actually going to pick up my first pinball game. Yes, I'm super excited. I'm stoked. I haven't slept in a day. And ideally what's going to be happening is, as you can tell by the title, I'm going to be picking up the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles pinball, one of my first pins I ever wanted since I started collecting in 2012. And finally, I'm going to pick up my grail. So hopefully everything goes well. Now, I'm a little early picking it up because I haven't technically done the challenge yet. If you guys don't know what I mean, I had a deal with my wife for from January 2nd, 2017 until May 1st, I would lose 45 pounds going back to what I was when I got married, and I'm doing very well, but this opportunity came up and it's one of the rare ones to find because they're a little tougher to find in Canada. So we're gonna go pick it up, and with my buddy, like last minute says, hey, we got a truck, let's go. I got the dolly in the back. Kevin, who's the seller, was on pin side. So I'm new to this website, and he's been really cool, and he goes, yes, and I just shot him a deal. Like, he wasn't selling it necessarily, and I'm like, yo, I heard you have one. I'm like, are you willing to sell it? Back and forth on pricing, you know, it needs some touch-ups, it needs some parts. The mini DMD, which is a little harder to find, is out, but apparently there's a new fix, I think by Boston Pinball, that has not only LEDs, but they're better because they're colored, which is really cool. So, you know, hopefully that's a good fix. I'm gonna try to fix it myself. Have my pinball guys help me out as well, and I'm very excited. So hopefully everything goes well. We're just about there, and let's pick up the Ninja Turtles pin.
Yep. All right, guys, we're back in the apartment, and it is official. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles pin comes to Top Tier, comes to the apartment. I was going to film the actual pickup on Kevin's basement, the guy I picked it up from, but his son was asleep, like he just put into bed, and we were kind of in a rush because there's a big accident on one of the major highways, and he felt a little nervous of me filming his game room because he had a lot of family pictures up and whatever. So I told him not to worry, it's not priority. So easy drive home, we lifted it. Going up the staircase was hell. Hand got a little mashed up, but nothing to worry about. So let me just show you guys around and what we're dealing with, the goods and bads. So first, let's deal with the bads. So the front looks a little mashed up. Apparently it's nothing that, you know, it can't be really fixed. Coin door, we can always fix the that's obviously for the legs, so I have the protectors, I'll show you that. Apparently this is all cosmetic, not to be too concerned. This looks like shit. I mean, that's the, I guess the operator had a coin thing, what's it called, a lockdown bar. So my guys told me not to worry whatsoever, because what we'll do is we'll bondo that. Later on, nothing too serious now, bundle that, match the green, which is actually like a matte green, so someone has the color scheme online, and then we'll just finish up Michelangelo's kind of side here, and then we're good. So that's the worst part of it. He did give me the Data East plastic here instead of the metal, which I'd want to replace, and the red. Maybe I'll get a custom rod either way. So that's the worst of it. Now, in the side cab, looks awesome. Now, other than here, like the lockdown bar, It needs a little attention because people's hands were kind of gripping it in the oils. That's not a big deal. Apparently, again, my guys can help. Side art, or the side of the cab, is damn near 10 out of 10. I mean, other, and because I haven't even washed it, I haven't kind of, see, there's, apparently that's just, it's just dirty. So it looks a little, it looks good. The sides look amazing, more than presentable. Again, in those corners, that's where you put the legs. Move the dolly out of the way. Side art here needs a little touch-up. Why Michelangelo has blue nunchucks, still to understand. Anyway, so the side looks more than presentable. Top is where the topper is going to go. That comes later. Let's check the other side. Other side's just as good. Little scrapes, a little scuffs here. But really presentable on the sides. And again, on the sides here, little, again, this is very easily cosmetically done. The front needs work, the sides, not really at all. The back, not that I care too much, looks really good. There are replacement stickers for these. Maybe I'd get one just to make it look a little better. That'll leave because it's original, that'll leave. Now this wire here, The guy modded it, Kevin modded it, and he put an LED, two LEDs on the bottom of the cab to kind of like glow green. I'm not sure how I feel about that now, but again, it's a quick release. I can just undo it, so I don't really care. Of course, there's the power plug. And let's get to the plate, the back glass. Let me run to it. Hey, Mary. Oh, shit. And then there's the legs of it, so there's that. Now, here's these protector things on the legs, so that's good. He gave me some extra stuff there. The back glass, I'm very pleased. It's mint. 100%. It's actually real glass. It's real glass. It's not a trans lens in the back. And the best part, let me show you the actual back of the glass. No flaking. I'm gonna wipe this down. But again, I'm not going to really touch anything for 24 hours because it was in the truck and it was exposed. I mean, I had a little blanket over it, but it was still a little cold. So that's good. The glass looks okay. Not too roughed up. I didn't even look in the back here. This is actually the first time I'm going to open the back. So he said I can wash this down. These are LEDs. So he did LED most of them. This is the DMD that the mini DMD. He did tell me that does not work. Now, a couple of my ping guys said, Steve, that doesn't mean anything because the high voltage might be off. So don't assume. So you never know. This can come off. Shit. One sec. Let me put you down. So I just moved this the speaker panel. There's a screw here. Let me undo, take that. I guess looks pretty clean. You know, the game in person, the game looks bigger. The game looks a lot bigger than I thought, I have to admit. But it is a little late, so I don't want to. Well, two things. I'm not going to turn it on because it was in the cold, and that's the rule number one. Plus, I want, because if you can touch the play field, it's cold. Let's open this. All right, is that normal? I don't like the battery right there. I'm going to remove those immediately in case that leaks. So that's good. There's no leakage on the board. Beautiful. Don't know really. It's a little beyond me. Don't know really what I'm looking at. I can push that back, so that's going to be an easy fix. At least it looks pretty clean in here. I really don't know what I'm really looking at, in a sense, good or bad. Only thing I want to do for sure is get rid of that immediately, the batteries, or at least replace them. But he says he did replace them. You can see he chose 2024, so should be okay. Should be. Again, I'm not going to really do anything until my pin guys come and give me a school lesson on this. But, yeah. I mean, it works. I mean, the only thing that doesn't work that he showed me is the DMD. And again, little things we have to do. So that's done. And then I'll show you. Let me just put this back up. One second, please. Alright. Okay. Alright. Alright, so that's that. Let me just show you inside real quick. This is interesting. Thank God it came with a key. I don't want to be drilling it out. Okay. Inside. So there's a loose speaker. There's a serial number, which is great. We'll look at that later. I can't even see. You guys will be able to see better than me. 41, whatever. So it's official, which is good. I always like the serial number, even though it looks good. Inside of the cab looks pretty clean. Again, I'll wipe it down, but I'm not going to touch anything. It's a 3-slot coin door. I don't know how I feel about that because the original is 2. Maybe not a bad thing because, again, this is in Canada. Again, we have loonies. You can see how big that slot is. So I don't know if I'm going to keep this coin door, do a 1-slot instead. Or a 2-slot, I should say. I'm sorry. Not sure. Weird. It's actually, when I open the coin door, it's cold. It's almost like a fridge. So let's look at the play field. The most important. So it looks pretty good. I'll show you the parts that I'm a little concerned about. Again, my guys told me not to worry. Again, nothing's ever perfect, but not to worry. The toys are on. It looks pretty good. There are some plastics that I know are chipped or needs replaced. Not a big deal. Looks pretty good. Critic List, Leonardo. So the pizza deco looks faded. Again, I can find one online that's an easy restore. He did put these targets here. I'm not sure how I feel about them yet. We'll see. I mean, you know, it's a $30 change if I have to. The only concern I have, which kind of sucks, but again, everyone's like, don't worry too much about it because it looks worse than it is apparently. So hopefully that's legit talk, is right here. This is the only part. Now that looks, when I first saw this, I was a little worried, I'm not gonna lie. The green posts were changed from black, which is good. You know, a couple of broken plastics here. But again, apparently these are pretty easy to find. But more importantly, it's this. So apparently, he was telling me the Mylar, he tried to move it, and that's glue. So this black is the glue from the Mylar. Now, obviously it's been lifted, and it looks like shit, and it worries me. But my guys are like, it's probably not as bad as you think if you wax it. And then if not, we might be able to fill it in, or we'll find something. So this part worries me, but it's something that they said not to be too concerned about. And again, you can see the insert there. If I ever had to shop it out, you just undo it and just do the yellow. So it does need touch-ups, you know, it does need touch-ups there as well. As I look at this for the first time, it does need a little work. So I guess, you know, it's mainly meant to enjoy, right? I don't know if I'm going to replace these all. I don't know if they're all supposed to be, I don't know the color scheme yet. Other than this part, and you know, and then just so it's rough around there. And lastly, he told me about this, so nothing was a lie. It's kind of ghetto. Like he used like something to just block the, I don't know what that is. I think it's a coil sleeve or something to block the ramp because that was broken. But not that big of a not that big of a deal. There's a lot of good things, which is this part of it. Other than the DMD is working, I was gonna switch it to the color one anyways. Hopefully, if I can get that working, I just save more money where I can do it and maybe restore this. Maybe I'll get my guys to come and give me an opinion or to touch it up and then clear coat it. I don't know. So I want to get their opinion, but it does play, so everything else works. I guess the hard part works. I do wish that looked a little better, but there's no option. So not perfect, but definitely the best one I've seen here in Canada. I think I paid a fair price. I paid $2,000 cash Canadian. You know, even I was looking online before I did this. If I can get that DMD working, even if it's for now, the back glass alone, a brand new one, like because it's real glass, is around $400. So that alone, I'm good. Everything else, I mean, he did replace some flippers and whatever, so there's some good. Only thing, and the toys are on, but I'd probably add a couple more. But either way, I'm not going to turn it on. What I'll do is we're going to let it kind of let it chill out for the night. And then tomorrow when I come back from work, I'll do a video with the legs on and with it on just to show you that it's working. And then kind of maybe just do a 2-minute gameplay just to show it working. And then from there, we go on the endeavor to do a full in and out of the cabinet and take it from there. So guys, I'll see you tomorrow when we're a little more prepared to open it and then get an opinion on all my ping guys. Okay. All right, everyone, it's the next morning and a little sore. Both my back and my hands are moving it, but definitely worth it. So here's the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles pinball. It's all set up on four legs, has the protectors here that was included. Inside was pretty clean. Let it kind of settle in a room temperature. Found the manual, like I said. Which has been a big help because I've been looking at things to replace and you know, things to change later on. So here's the game. Here's what it looks like with a transit. Like I said before, damn near 100%. I don't see anything. I think there's one little hole right there. But we're talking very minimal. But either way, almost damn near perfect. It runs pretty well. I've been playing it here and there. Definitely need some work, but not perfect. I've been talking to my pinball guys about, you know, refreshing that part of the play field that looks a little rough. I've got some ideas. They've definitely calmed me down because I was getting really worried that, you know, because I wanted to almost be, not a showpiece, but, you know, definitely playable, but also, you know, very presentable. So another good thing, I found these, the cards here, the instruction card and the pricing card, saves me a couple bucks, which is always good. And so why don't we go ahead and turn it on?
Teenage Mutant Ninja! Awesome!
See, it does that sometimes because I've left credits in or something with the interlock. I did find the volume controls right there, by the way, because it was a little low. This speaker should be there, I think, and then that's maybe where the shaker motor or one of the other. I don't know. I'm very new to this and just been asking everyone, but it's been playing very well, I have to admit. It's pretty decent. I know the flippers are a little weak, but it is what it is. So let's coin up. Now again, I can't see the DMD screen because that's what's out. So I'm looking and asking my guys how to fix that. So we'll look into it. Don't know where the test switch is, but I just coin up.
Excellent!
All right. Oop. What do I do here? There we go. So I just press start. Ooh, that's loud. So I just plunge the show. So flippers are a little weak. Ooh, that's loud. Now, I never added this. The seller added it's a green LED strip. It doesn't look too bad. I don't know if I'm going to keep it later, but it's up to me. That's who's with the lights off and plunge again. Now a cool thing is it has the kickback. Watch. If I miss it twice, it does an automatic kickback. Which is good. Anyway, so there's the game. So far so good, you know, it's turn that up. So that's the game in a nutshell. Let me just turn the light on. So guys, this was the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Pinball Part 1, the pickup. Don't want to run it too long, so that's pretty much the game. What I usually do is take a list, like a checklist of what I want replacing, what I want to see done. For an example, DMD working. LEDs are already here, maybe just change a few that I have, play field, which is a big deal, you know, changing the toys up as far as maybe adding more or like rearranging them, and of course work done in the cabinet. So and then even replacing this with like buttons that are lit up. So there's work to be done. The play field mainly, again, the some plastics, like that one is broken. I went through with it just not too long ago, but There is a good amount to do, but you know, one step at a time. As I learn pinball, it's a new endeavor. Definitely down the rabbit hole I go, and so be it. So Tajima Arcade Collection. So guys, you know what? This is just the beginning. The part two, I'm going to be reviewing the cabinet, showing some features of the game, and overall going in and out. Maybe lift the play field and the back glass, and take it from there. So guys, it's been a pleasure. Thanks again for checking out Top Tier. If you haven't had a chance to subscribe yet, please do so. And if you're new to my channel and you're a pinhead or a pinball guy or an arcade looking to get into pinball like myself, we'll learn it together, because this is, like I said, a new endeavor that is going to take a lot of attention and another type of skill set, because it is a different type of... It's an arcade hobby, but it's different just because pins are kind of like the cousin of it. There's a lot of, you know, a lot of things are similar. Obviously, coin doors are similar, buttons are similar, plunges are new. You know, obviously the mechanics, but PCB and running things and power and voltages is pretty much the same. Very exciting, very happy to have one of my grills. I do want it to look perfect when I'm done with it. It does need work, but again, this is a work in progress, one step at a time. If you want to join the journey with me, hit the subscribe button and let's take it together. Guys, thanks again for checking out Top Tier. My name is Steve. Peace.